My years in the Navy and D-Day and the other landings certainly made me mature quickly. I learned a lot about leadership. When I first went on the ship, I found I was in charge of a group of 54 men. All of them were older than I was. All of them had been in the Navy longer than I had, and all of them had been on the ship longer, some much longer than I had been on the ship. I learned how to get along with other people, and people being led expect some separation between themselves and the leaders. Not too much, but some. I tried to find things I could do to make their life a little easier. And I learned that action speaks louder than words, and promises don't mean anything to them. They don't believe them. And then at Goldman Sachs, I learned a lot of things about leadership. We had a wonderful morale of the people. Teamwork, I was all for. Integrity was a big thing that I stood for, doing what's right. So the idea was that if you do things right and honestly and straightforwardly, always, you will be a better firm doing that. Then I retired, went to the State Department, was a Deputy Secretary of State. I found it easier to adapt to foreign policy than I had expected, but at Goldman Sachs I had learned a lot of things about leadership. I knew a lot of foreign businessmen and foreign leaders from helping to make Goldman Sachs international. It was 4 wonderful years in which I like to think that we, President Reagan and George Shultz and I, all three helped end the Cold War. And then I went on to 25 years of working just with nonprofits and have had a lot of leadership positions with them. I learn every day. It isn't that I put my old training to work. It's more or less that I realized what it takes to be a leader of each organization and how to do it well.